I want you to know, Jack, you died for nothing.
I saved you a bullet. In last night's final episode of Lost, which you saw right here on KITV4, the evil man in black, or John Locke, was finally defeated. And joining us this morning for the final Lost interview is Ryan Ozawa. Good morning, Ryan.
Oh, good morning.
Thank you so much for joining us.
Definitely. Wow. It was a long evening, still a little sleep deprived, but overall, that was definitely an epic ending there.
Yeah, what a tearjerker. What are all the fans saying after last night?
I think that the story was just right. I loved it. It's not as clear-cut as a lot of people were hoping. I kind of like that it is a little controversial and that there's still some debate, but I think that the writers made the conscious decision between the mysteries that people were invested in and the characters that people were invested in and said, we want to close out the character story. The mysteries, we can argue about for the rest of our lives, but they wanted to kind of put that away, and that's really what it felt like.
And one of the big questions was, who was going to be the protector of the island?
Yeah.
And it was answered. Let's take a look at this clip.
You're not supposed to die. The island needs you.
Really? It needs you. It needs to be you, Hugo. I believe in you.
And he really is the unluckiest lottery winner ever. Because he should be out there spending millions, you know, hanging out resorts with scantily clad women. Instead, he's going to be watching this island.
But, you know, I like that ending. I mean, so last week we discussed it, and we were talking about how Jack takes over that job. And you were like, it's Hurley. And I'm like, no, it's not Hurley. You know, spoiler alert, it turns out.
It was Hurley,
you know. Jack basically had the job for half a day, and it turns out he needed that position to find the magical light. But it ends up Hurley is going to be the person watching over that. Going forward, unfortunately, Jack ends where he began, there on the ground in the bamboo jungle.
And Ryan, the controversial part of the whole episode was this flash sideways where they meet each other in eternity. So let's see that scene.
I don't understand. You died.
Yeah. Yes, I did.
Then how are you here right now?
How are you here?
I died too.
And it turns out everyone kind of ends up in heaven.
Yes,
or purgatory.
Essentially, well, Los Angeles, perhaps fittingly, like my wife said, well, of course, purgatory is Los Angeles. So the flash sideways was just a pause, a landing place for their souls before they can finally come together and walk into the light. For a lot of people, that was like, okay, just a bit, you know, too much, a step too far. I certainly wasn't expecting that for the flash sideways either. I thought they were a great exploration of the characters, but the overall significance of it, I didn't anticipate that. But I think that, again, it comes down to how they wanted to say goodbye to the characters. To me, the series finale, I was expecting answers and all of that. Now I'm like, you know, it really was just a celebration of the journey that they've been on. There were several scenes that made me cry, mostly because they went back and sort of flashed through each of these characters' lives. So to me, that was fitting. But in terms of a controversial ending, like the end of Newhart, it was all a dream, or St. Elsewhere and stuff, this is going to be up there in terms of people arguing whether that was great or not.
Ladies and gentlemen, Lost podcaster and our expert, Ryan Ozawa. Ryan, thanks so much for being
here.
How many
Ryan.
Years? 4 years? Five years here
now? And you know, 6 years
Ryan.
For the show. Thank you.
And we say goodbye to Jack. You know, he dies at the end of the show, and we leave you now with that scene. Thanks, Ryan.
My pleasure.